minutes of the last meeting? Great, thank you. And if we go on to the fourth item on the agenda, Liverpool City Region Commander Authority quarterly update report, Dave Knott.
Internal audit Now, the advantage of that, obviously, is that it maximises the local input into the appointment of auditors. However, that could be quite a costly setup, and it also means that we won't be able to take advantage of any reduced audit rates that may be available from any nationally arranged contracts. The second option is to set up a joint audit panel or a joint procurement arrangement, and that would basically mean collaborating with the local authorities to set up a joint panel. Now, while that would reduce the cost of setting up the panel, and there may be some scope for a more economies of scale, potentially there's no direct involvement of elected members, and it could also be complicated whereby different authorities have different auditors and they're using them in different capacities. So, for example, some local authorities and other public sector bodies will use certain of large firms as consultants, and therefore they won't feel able to use them for their external auditor because you can't have the two doing the same job. Also, preliminary discussions locally suggest that there isn't really any appetite for that option. The third option is to opt into a sector-led body. Now, that would be a body that would be appointed by the Secretary of State, and the sector-led body would have the ability to negotiate contracts for all those bodies that are opted in. The advantage for us would be that the cost of setting up the body would be an awful lot cheaper because it's shared across all those organisations opted in. There's likely that the grid rates that would be offered would be reduced because you've got the economies of scale. The obvious disadvantage is there's no direct involvement in the appointment of the auditors. In terms of way forward, we have until December this year to make a decision as to which option we want to progress with. But in practical terms, we need to know what we want to do by 2017. So in terms of considering the options, we need to be mindful of the fact that Merseytravel's accounts are consolidated into those of the combined authority. And therefore, we need to ensure that the financial management and audit arrangements of the two bodies are aligned. The view of Merseytravel's audit and risk governance was that the PSSA and the sector-led body was the preferred approach. I'm happy to take any questions anyone may have on that.
Again, CA, just to get through yourself there, the facts that report are very, very concise methods. So it's going to be a given number of awful options to be. Yes, a alternative. It makes sense, it's cost effective. The position will be a much better sense in the state of the system. So I would be advocating that we have four options.
Yes, I talk about the use of force. Option three is the best option, cost effective, and it's wholly independent. So there'll be no accusations of, well, how did the appoint them? It's wholly independent, that's our hands. I fully support that. So we look at, there's no further comments.
I'd just like to comment, Chair. That was my impression as well. I was worried about the independence, but I think option three is the best way forward.
So, if it's from the recommendations, the second part of the recommendation is to recommend the combined authority preferred option. And we, from this committee, we're happy to recommend option three to the combined authority to move forward. Have everybody agreed on that? Making the committee recommendation in paragraph two? Financial monitoring report, quarter one, 2016-17. This has previously been on the last committee. Quarter two wasn't available at the printing of these papers. However, it is available now. We're looking at a verbal update. Accept the notes available review of quarter two, if that's satisfactory for the committee. John, can I
think just to explain the situation, it's a little bit unusual. The combined authority meeting of the 16th of December will receive a revised budget for the combined authority, and should it approve it, and that will obviously set the new baseline which we'll monitor. That report is available, but until the CA approve the revisions to the budget, it's difficult to come here with a meaningful budget monitor as such. The reason being, obviously, is that the budget that the combined authority determined in February, for the most part, is unchanged, because that the majority of expenditure is around the grant to Merseytravel, the transport levy, the special rail grant, but the big chunky items that pass to Merseytravel, they're unchanged. But CA bullying costs, and in particular combined authority income related to devolution, has changed significantly because of all the activity that's happened this year, the capacity work, but more importantly the gain share money, that £30 million, which until relatively very recently we've been told we were going to get it, but we didn't know that we were going to get it. So the CA will hopefully accept those revisions next Friday, and then we'll have something to benchmark against. But just in terms of a verbal update around financial performance, Merseytravel, in terms of its operating grant and its grant for operating the tunnels, is forecast to have a slight underspend in those areas across the number. It's up and down across a number of areas, and the Merseytravel committee received the detailed information last week and considered it. But at the moment, I think in terms of the risk of any material overspend in Merseytravel, that risk would be low. The combined authority, again, the only budget really that should fluctuate is around running costs and the transitional costs. So for this year, the CA approved a budget for running costs and costs of transition of £2 million. And that's looking pretty much like that's what will be spent this year. And you'll be aware of the activities that's funding. On capital, a local growth fund, situation is slightly different. Again, there's an awareness that there will, in all likelihood, be quite significant underspend on growth fund this year. And that's predominantly related to the pause in the employment and skills that was completely dictated by the area based review. So we are lobbied and having conversations with government on how best to kind of acknowledge and recognise that isn't to the detriment of the combined authority. And there's other LGS schemes as well that have encountered difficulties in getting going as a result predominantly a lot of the network rail issues that have been reported to the combined authority. But all in all, that washes through as a likely underspend on LGF this year. But again, as has been previously reported, LGF as a programme is on target. It's just that there's been delays in starting a number of projects, and obviously the area based review had a big impact. That's pretty much all I want to say about it, other than it's a verbal update at the moment. That's okay.
Thank you very much, John. Any questions or comments in relation?
Just being a member of the CA.
So what I'll do with that, the recommendations of paragraph 2, they recommend that we've noted quarter 1, well you noted that last time, quarter 2 will catch up with our next committee. So what I'll ask the committee to do is to accept and note the verbal review of quarter 2. You have to accept and note the verbal review?
Yes.
Thank you. Move on to item number 9. Code of Corporate Governance revised. Again, John
encapsulates what where the command authority is at. It's a draft. It's really by way of the table to the back, by way of a self-assessment. So we have principles of good governance which have come from this, from the code of practice. And then in the next column, how the combined authority is discharging those responsibilities in terms of good governance. And you know that we're happy to answer any questions on this. Had the opportunity to see hopefully the tables at the back. I think the recommendation is that this gets submitted to the combined authority if you're happy with it for approval. It's the CA itself that will need to adopt that, this document.
Thank you very much, John. Any comments, questions regarding this report? No? Pretty standard.